What's up, Coleman? How you doing, man?
What's up to the best voice in the business? Your voice.
Oh, man, that's a huge compliment coming from you. I was going to say, I'm about to give you a new nickname, man. You remind me a lot of Nas, man. Every movie you jump on, you just elevate. You're a fire starter, man.
You're
a fire starter, dude. You kill it. I love your dedication and commitment to every single role you do. It's just unbelievable, man.
I appreciate it.
You're always on top of your game. Let's talk Candyman. Do you remember the original?
I remembered it because I didn't watch it because I was
terrified. Isn't that crazy?
I was terrified. No, I was like, nah, you know, black people don't summon things. I don't want to watch anything that's going to bring any more trauma than I need. So I stayed away from it. But,
right.
But that's why I'm really happy that we have a spiritual sequel. Like, this is something I would actually watch and I would run towards because I feel it's really dealing with themes that I think are really relevant and I can sort of unpack in a healthy way.
isn't that crazy though? Has there ever been a movie where more people admitted to not watching but know all about it?
Yeah, you know, you talk about it. Because, but you're like, I ain't gonna watch it. Listen, I think it's because, you know, black people, we deal with a lot of trauma on a daily basis. And I don't know if I want to invite more in. But now I think we're in a different place where we're willing to do the work and the examination, because I think the genre has been elevated. And I think that's a large part due to Jordan Peele and the way that we examine, the way we can see and unpack our stuff. There's great sense of humor in there. There's sarcasm, there's wit. There's great themes and intellectual examinations and happening. So I think that's the way we can really lean into it, which is cool.
Yeah, I love it. And it's primarily based on an urban legend. So I want to ask you, what's the craziest urban legend you ever heard about?
The craziest urban legend I've ever heard about. Can we talk about this? I don't know. There are two people looking at me over here, like, because I never come up with a good answer. you know what? I think, again, I'll just say I've stayed away from urban legends because I think I'm very sensitive. And I just turn a deaf ear. I hear more the crazier stories, the stories that make me laugh and, like, you know, things that have happened to people.
Okay. I love your attitude. So then let me flip it on you then on this other thing that the movie deals with. And it deals with hardship, which you said you like to avoid. But I do want to ask you, when you're having a tough day on the set, what do you do to cope with hardship?
What do I do to cope with hardship? I think I'm a person, especially now as I'm 51 years old, I deal with it head on. I think I don't have a lot of time to let it just, you know, simmer and go inside my body. I actually just deal with it and just talk about it so it doesn't carry over. I think that's the healthiest way. I deal with it head on.
Wow. You know,
ain't nobody got time for that. To just like swallow it and keep on moving and go into your trailer mad. No. Can I talk to you for a minute? Let's talk about this and let's find a better way to be. There we go. I
love it, man. It's all based on intelligence. But once again, man, thanks a lot, man. You guys really killed it with this movie, man. You took it to a whole different level. And like I said, every time you lay something, you take it there. So thanks a lot.